that understandable misimpression than Niger Congo. And so sometimes people ask me, you know, what's your favorite language? You know, if you think your own English is so boring, which I do, what's your favorite? And I, of course, give a different answer every time. But one of them that I've always given is Fula. Fula is a Niger Congo language, and it is a member of a family called, not very helpfully, Atlantic, subfamily, that is. And these are languages spoken in Senegal and thereabouts. The most famous Atlantic language is Wolof of Senegal, but frankly, I find more interesting Fula. And Fula is extremely conservative, as Niger Congo languages go, in that business with the genders, it really takes it further than you can imagine any language doing it. It's just delightful to me to imagine that there are people walking around speaking this without tripping over their shoelaces, having a stroke, or needing some sort of major medical intervention every time they try to rub a noun and a verb together. This language has as many as 20, quote-unquote, genders. Not in terms of people, but in terms of what objects are like, except in this language, the genders don't really correspond to anything in the real world like shape or personhood or sex. Really, you just have to know what every noun has in terms of what its markings are going to be. And so, let's say that you know that something like orange is part of one of these classes. And so, you know that there's a suffix that it has. This time, it's a language that does suffixes. It's ray. And so the word for orange is lemu. Sounds kind of like lemon. That's cute, which I never noticed until right now. But lemu, so that's orange. And then lemure, that's the gender that we use. Now, there's a kind of a rule of thumb as to what belongs in this class. It's kind of like round things, but it kind of stretches it, and to a large extent you have to know, but lemure. Now you think, okay, in this round-ish class of things, that means that everything is going to have that re suffix, right? Well, no, it's going to have something like it, and it's unpredictable. So lemure, okay. Jar is lo. Lo re? No. Lo ne. So re and ne are the same thing, but different. It's kind of like I once knew a guy who had 9 different pairs of sneakers, a different color for all of his clothes. You can imagine what he was like. He had all these different sneakers. Well, that's kind of like these suffixes. And so, lemure, red, you know, sneakers. Lo, ne, is yellow sneakers. Except, lemu isn't red and lo isn't yellow. You really just kind of have to know. Calabash, that's round, too. And so, tumu, that's calabash. It sounds kind of like one. But it's not tumure or tumude. It's tumu. De, not de, but just de. You just have to know. So that's part of what it is to speak Fula. And then you have the adjectives. And when you put an adjective with a noun, it doesn't take the ending that the noun has. The adjective often has a different one than the noun. So big orange. So lemu re, and then big is mau. Lemu re, mau re. No, that's the kind of Fula where they would go, hee hee, you don't talk right. It's lemu re mau ne. And you just have to know. And ladies and gentlemen, this is not a written language. This is the sort of thing where many very well-intentioned people would say, oh yeah, and they speak their dialect. This is a dialect? How is this less sophisticated than German? And get this, this is my favorite thing about Fula. People actually speak this. You add a plural suffix, and it's not just as simple as that. When you add the plural, it's as if there's some kind of magic happening. And so it's like quantum physics where one thing happens in one place and it makes something happen in a different place. If you put the plural suffix on, then the sound up at the front of the word changes for no darn reason. And so, for example, man, gore, okay? You ask a speaker, how do you say man? Gore. But really, gore, co. That's the suffix that you have. Gore, co. Okay. Now, what's the suffix if you make it plural? It becomes be, which is weird enough. Why ko and then be? You just have to know it. So, be. So, how do you say men? You would think, if you're taking Fula 101, which is, of course, offered in public schools across the nation, you'd think it would be gore be. No, no. It's war be. So, gore, ko, gore be, no. War be. And you just have to know. So if you're speaking Fula, you have to know which of these quote unquote genders a word belongs to, and really, as often as not, you just kind of have to know. Then you have to know which pair of sneakers to use in terms of that suffix, because you really can't, you just have to know. Then you have to know, and it's not only with the plural, but with the plural in other cases, you have to know whether or not the consonant at the beginning is going to change to something else, and what is it going to change to? That's what it is to speak Fula. It is one of the most delightfully, viciously complicated languages I have ever seen. And yet this is the sort of thing where some mustachioed imperialist would go through and say, ah, yes, the dialect of the natives. And even today, somebody would say, oh, well, I was talking to this person. Oh, yeah, he speaks French. Yeah, we were speaking French. It was wonderful. Oh, yeah, he also, well, he has his native dialect. And the dialect will often be Fula, which is something more complicated than anything that exists in Europe other than roughly Lithuanian and Latvian. And, you know, if you put any Slavic language except Bulgarian, Macedonian, in the ring with Fula and had them fight, I imagine that Polish would hold up until the very end, but Fula would be the one with its gloves up in the air. This is one of the clumsiest analogies I've ever made, but you get the point. So that is a lesson in this business of dialect, not a dialect at all. It's a diorama, absolutely amazing. Then there are the other languages, and they're impressive in different ways. And I don't mean in terms of, all of my children are special. I mean, really, there is some stuff going on with these languages, which otherwise can look quote unquote simple. And so, for example, just to review the norm, in many Niger Congo languages, you can get an awful lot into one word. And so, for example, if you want to say something like, let's see what the dog will do. And you can take a meat and potatoes Niger Congo language like Swahili. Dog is mwa, which does sound like wah, 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 wah. That's Dino. Wah, 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 wah. That like that, so mwa. So let's see what the dog will do. And so it's tumtazame, mwa, tak of your fun. And so the tumtazame alone is let's, you've got the let's in there, let's look at him. And so tumtazame, mwa, that's let's look at him and then the dog. And you have to even be redundant. The dog, and then let's.